Okay, back at it. Hope you like the Mars or Barstow game from Jay Leno there. I thought that's just hilarious. But anyway, back at it then. There's this issue of wanting to go to Mars someday. Maybe the Earth is on decline because of climate change or overpopulation, so maybe we'd like to go to another planet someday. Their company many years ago called Mars One decided they wanted to do that, and they sent some appeal out to see if there's any volunteers that would go. And very quickly, they got 100,000 people signed up that would want to go to Mars. So there's a lot of issues about going to Mars, something that Elon Musk talks about a lot these days. Some things to think about. What are some of the issues going to Mars? And when you think about it, if you were there or somehow got to the planet here, what would it really be about? Is it just about air, food, and water? Certainly, these are going to be some important things to consider, but is that all? So we'll have to think about that a little bit. Going to Mars. Some of the considerations there. This is a comet. And there's been a few comets that you can see in the sky from time to time. I've seen a few in my lifetime alone. We'll have to talk about what comets are. They seem like they sort of have a central core like this, and they're going. But one of the questions I'd like you to think about just even right now is, would it be possible for you to look at this comet here and tell me the direction that it's moving in? Comets definitely move through the solar system. And what direction would this comet be moving in? Think about that a little bit. Europe sent a spacecraft called Rosetta. This was some time ago, maybe in 2014 or so, to actually go chase down a comet. So this is an actual photograph of this spacecraft heading towards this comet here. There's the comet that is sort of encountered there. And when it got close, this is sort of what the comet looked like very up close like this. It was a very peculiar object here, and they targeted it because it's something they could travel to in a reasonable amount of time. Looks like it's definitely consists of two parts here, sort of maybe fused together in the center here for whatever reason. And you may not be able to see it very well on the YouTube video here, but if you look at it very carefully, there's actually this wispy stuff coming off the comet. So the question is, what is that? I'm just going to call it wispy stuff right now. What is it, and why does it form? So this is a close-up view of a comet. I think the closest we've ever gotten. There's one right there. Sizes in astronomy are always fun to think about here, because on this figure here, that's a picture of downtown Los Angeles, and that's how big that comet would be if it was near the city. Sometimes there's movies and talk about these things hitting the Earth, and you can see it would be sort of a bad thing if one of these actually did hit the Earth for reasons you can imagine there. I love telescopes. I have one myself, and there's a lot to talk about. I'll tell you many things about telescopes. But one thing that you sort of see that they have in common that you might want to think about is they're all always sort of long like this. They have this long direction like this and like this and like this. And this one even is so high that this person here is sort of stands up to look into it here. So the question is, why are they always so long like this? And they always sort of have some common components to them. Like there's a little part right there and a little part right there. I don't know where it is on this one right here at the moment, but there's a part right there and a part right there that you sort of look into. So we'll have to sort of talk about that. And what are some of these structures about? Like these comets always have, these telescopes always have these bucket shapes like that. And so what are those about? And this one sort of has a bucket shape, but it's actually sort of empty there. There's no side or casing right there. So is that okay, or why is that? So we'll definitely have a nice long talk about telescopes. The other thing that always sort of cracks me up about telescopes is the ads. They're very, very corny, these ads. So, for instance here, do you always have to hike up to a high mountain in order to use a telescope? And, you know, what exactly are they smiling at here? Why are they using the telescope in the middle of the day? Here's a whole family here. Looks like how serious the dad is here, getting the daughter to take a look in there. And looks like the mom and son are sort of waiting patiently, looking at the what? Bird, clouds, don't know. Ads for telescopes are just terrible, so I'll have to tell you a bit about those. And it turns out that sometimes you see these from time to time around the world. Like one of these here is even in going up to Mammoth, California, and there's a couple others around the world. So what are these things here? Is this all about satellite TV? Well, it turns out, no, that these things here are also telescopes. These are telescopes pointed at the sky, but they don't look at visible light at all. They look at radio waves that come in from outer space. So we'll talk about these, and we'll continue this in the next video.